Well, you are all doing well. As you know, CBC changed syllabus and in 402 information technology subject. Now they are using Open Office instead of MS Word. Here we'll understand the unit 1 digital documentation, nothing but writer advanced options. First session we'll understand how to do create and apply styles in a document. Okay, these things we'll look into these things, and we'll do some exercises. These examples we'll do it, and we'll understand thoroughly how to do create and apply styles in a document. Before we start, let us understand what is open source. What is meant by open source? OpenSource.org, OOO, commonly known as OpenOffice, is a discontinued open source office suite. OpenOffice include a word processor, which is Writer, a spreadsheet, it is called as CAC, a presentation application, it is known as Impress, and a drawing application as a Draw, a formula editor for maths, and database management application as a base. What is the use of OpenOffice Writer? OpenOffice Writer is a word processor, part of OpenOffice software package. Writer is a word processor that is like Microsoft Word and Corel's Word Perfect. Just like all of the OpenOffice suite, Writer can be used on many operating systems, including macOS, Microsoft Windows, Linux, FreeBSD, and Solaris. These are the different kinds of operating systems. Now we understand what is difference between OpenOffice and a Microsoft Office. One key underlying difference between Microsoft Office and OpenOffice is that Microsoft Office is produced by for a profit company that uses some of its revenue for research and development. OpenOffice is an open source software. It is developed by collaboratively by mostly voluntaries, and it is free to use. Okay, now you understand what is open source and what is Writer. We'll start here according to your syllabus curriculum, how to create and apply styles in the document. So what I'll do, I'll go to my desktop and I'll open OpenOffice. This is a OpenOffice shortcut key. We can start open from start also, but I'll open from here only. It is developed under the Apache. Okay, this is Apache OpenOffice theme 4. Okay, here you'll get all the packages which are included in this. Now we'll go for a text document, which is nothing but a writer or a word processor. Okay, we'll get spreadsheet, presentation, drawing, database, formula, all things we'll get here, but we'll open text document. Okay, this is your OpenOffice Writer, which looks like same as a MS Word. Okay, nothing much differences, but main difference is it is open source and Microsoft. It is a licensed version which you have to purchase. Now, as for your syllabus, creating and applying styles in a document. It is a digital documentation, advanced things. So we'll learn how to do these things. So before I start these things, I'll type some text here. Hello, students. Okay. I'll type hello, students again. I'll repeat these two words so we'll understand clearly what is styles. Okay. Now, here we are styles creating in the word processor, styles and formatting windows, fill format, and all these things we learn and we'll understand here how to use it. Now before I start, how to open a style? There are many options to open a style in a writer. One option is you can use function F11. It will open a style in formatting, or else you can go here, there is an icon. Okay, there is an icon in the left side. You can use this. If you click, it will open. Or one more option, third option, format, style line formatting. You can see here F11 is shortcut key is F11. Okay, this is three options where with the help of these three options we can open this style and formatting. Okay, we'll understand what are things are available here. This is for paragraph styling, character styling, frame styles, page styles, and list styles. Today we'll understand paragraph style. It is very useful tool when you are doing a big documents, like if you are putting a heading, subheadings. Okay, there are many options are available here. Different heading styles are there, first line indent. Okay, we'll apply all those things and we'll understand how it will affect our document. To apply these headings and styles, you have to select the text. Okay, keep in mind, without selecting nothing will happen. You have to select the text which you want to apply the style. So what I'll do, I'll put as a first line indent. I'll just double click on this. You can see here hanging indent, it is changing. Okay, now I'll go for default. See, okay, now heading 1, you can see here, or heading 10. So many different styles are available, different types of headings are available. We can apply just by double clicking the different styles. Okay, so now I'll go again default, so it will come back to default. Now we'll go for your syllabus. Fill format. First we'll understand what is fill format. Okay, here you can see here there is a fill format mode. This is nothing but a paste. It will be having a paste format, no, in MS Word, same thing it is. So now what I'll do, I'll use this tool. Before using this tool, I'll change this first line to a heading. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll select this fill format. You can see here, after selecting that, you'll get a bucket. What is use of this? When you want to apply this same style for different words or different lines, you can use this. Okay, instead of going and clicking every time, just select the word which you want to apply every verb, and just select this fill format and go on selecting. It will fill the format as you selected before. This is called fill format. I hope you understood this. Okay, fill format means nothing but it will paste the format or a style which you selected to other words or a lines. Okay, you can see here for all words I did it. So this is called a fill format. Okay, I hope you understood this. Clear. Next I'll go for new option. What is that? Creating and updating a new style from selection. Okay, creating and updating a new style from selection. Okay, to create a, I'll go back, I'll cancel this. Okay, just click here, it will go. I have to click back to that, it will go. Now I want to create new style, my own new style for this document. Okay, these are the default, but I want to create my new one. So what I'll do, I'll select this, I'll change to bold, I'll make it bigger, little bit bigger font size, italic, underlined, I'll color it and I'll put some highlighter. So you can see here. Okay, now I want to update this style in this style and formatting tool. Okay, so what I have to do, just select this text, go here. Okay, here it is a new style from the selection. It is called a new style from the selection. Click here, new style from the selection. Select new style from the selection. Now you have to give a name. Okay, so what I'll give? I'll give a STY, a style. Okay, now what I'll do? I will update style. You can see here the style which I created is displaying here. So I want to apply this style for this document. What I'll do? See, when I click here, it going to default. Now I'll just select this, double click on this. You can see here the style which I used for this, it is applied for this also. Now once again we'll see, we'll create one more style. So I'll use this, I'll increase the font size, and I'll change only font color, that is chocolate color, and I'll make it is a bold. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll create a new style from the selection. From the selection means which I am selecting this word. Okay, now go here, new style. Okay, which I created old one it is. Okay, now I'll type one. Okay, now I'll update this. You can see a style one came. Okay, now I want to apply the for this text. I'll just double click. See, this is how you can create a new style from the selection. Okay, next we'll see what they given. We'll go for next. Load styles from a template or another document. Loading a style from different document. Okay, another document. So what I'll do, I'll go a new document, I'll create a new document. I'll press Ctrl N, it'll open a new document. Okay, you can see here whichever I created for a last document, those are not displaying here. Observe it carefully. The whichever I created for the old document, for this document, see, these styles are not visible here. These styles are only meant for this document. Now what I'll do, I'll create a style here, students. Okay, now I'll do some stylish style here. We'll use this. I'll bold it, and I'll increase the size to around 28. I'll make it center, underlined, color it. I'll make it some red. Okay, you can see I created a style. Now this style I have to update here. So what I'll do, I'll select this, create a new style from selection, same thing last what you did, style. Okay, from document, other document. Okay, I'll type whole thing, from other doc, other document. Okay, I'll click it. You can see a style from other document. Now what I'll do, I'll update this style. Now this style I want to apply here. Okay, this style I want to apply here. So what they're telling, load styles from a template or another document. I have to load this style from here to here. So what I have to do, first you have to do, you have to save this file. Without saving, you can't import the style for other document. Okay, now I'll save the file. I just click on the save as. Okay, now where I'll save it, I'll save in a documents. Okay, I'll save it as a style. File extension is ODT, it is open text document file extension. I'll save the file. Okay, I saved the file. You can see here style.odt, the file is saved. Now I'll go here. Okay, now I will import that style here from other document. Okay, you can see here load style. Okay, there is an option called load style. Click on this, it'll open a dialog box, load style, go from file. Okay, we have to select from another file. No, so select this from file, it'll open one more dialog box. I saved in a documents, type the file name. style.odt and click on open. Okay, now that style is loaded here. You can see here style from other document. Double click on this. See here, the style from this document is loaded here. Okay, we are importing the style from the different document. What I did, see once again. Okay, see once again. So I'll do one more style here. Okay, I'll see same. Now I'll do one thing. I'll copy this. I'll paste here. Instead of red, I'll use some other color, as I'll use blue color. Okay, now I'll select this. I'll create one more style, new style from selection. I'm doing this in another document, keep in mind. Okay, blue. Okay, update the style. Okay, I updated. Now first thing, you have to save. Without saving, it won't import anything. You have to save. What I did, I press Ctrl S shortcut key to save the file. Now I'll go here. Now I'll go here for another document. Now I want to load that style here. So for that, what I have to go, load style from file. Okay, what is the file name? style.odt. Select it, open it. Okay, now you can see blue might be coming here. So blue, you can see here that style is loaded here. This is how you can load style from different document. Next option, we'll see what they given. Creating a new style using drag and drop. Okay, how to create a style using drag and drop. So I'll use this word. I'll create some style for this. Okay, I'll change the color. Okay, now I'll change another color so you'll understand easily. I'll make it pink. Now what I have to do, what they are telling, creating a new style using drag and drop. Okay, what you have to do, select it, hold the right mouse key, don't leave, just drag it and bring to the style and formatting. What it will ask, it will ask you to create a style name. What I did, once again I'll tell you, select it, hold the right key, drag it. You know what is drag and drop, just click drop on style and formatting. It will ask for a name for the style. I'll put as a drag. You can see here drag style came. Now I apply this drag style here. I'll select this and I'll double click. This is how you can do by using drag and drop. Hope you understood all those things. If you have any queries, put a comments. I'll explain all those things. What is applying style? Applying style, just double clicking is called a applying style. Okay, just when I double click, no, it will apply. No, same thing. Okay, I hope you understand all these concepts. If you have any queries, please drop a message on a comment box. I will explain you in brief. Okay, thanks.